Kids don't forget.
Kids don't forget.
You kids don't forget.
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 So, Sharon, what up, man? How you feeling?
I'm good, baby. I'm good, you know?
What is the correct pronunciation of your name?
Sharon.
What's the correct spelling?
S-H-E-R-O-N.
Have you ever got your name mispronounced?
All the time.
What do you get?
Sharon.
You got Sharon?
Or Sharon.
Or Sharon.
Sharon or Sharon. If the person doesn't know, like if we communicate via email or something like that,
right.
More often it's Sharon.
Okay.
In person, if they know I'm a guy, they gonna say Sharon for the most part.
Okay. Yeah. Well, what do Tyler telemarketers pronounce your name?
Sharon. Sharon, I guess.
And it used to get misspelled a lot, too.
All the time.
Okay.
Yeah, with
so,
A.
So it's Sharon with one R, first of all.
S-H-E-R-O-N, correct.
Okay. How does it get misspelled?
All type of stuff. S-H-E-R-O-N-E, S-H-A-R-O-N, S-H-E-R-R-O-N, you know. Type of stuff.
Okay. Yeah. You're like, yo, it's Sharon with one R.
One R. Very easy.
Did you have any nicknames growing up?
Mr. Wu, my parents used to call me, but not often. And I never really had something that stuck. You know, like my brother got Buck, and you know, I never really had nothing that stuck.
Wait, where did Mr. Wu come from?
I had a rabbit or something like that, and
okay.
I named him Mr. Wu,
okay.
if I'm not mistaken. And I guess everybody thought it was like a silly name or whatever, so
right.
It just kind of stuck.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But in the hood, like in school, like everybody just called you Sharon.
Ron, for the most part. Most people just call me Ron or Sharon.
Okay.
You know? So I get Ron more than anything.
No Ronnies?
Most people, it's, you know, chicks back in the day.
Ronnie,
yeah,
you like
yeah,
that, you wasn't
yeah,
correcting them.
Yeah. Nah. It's a lot of people to this day. They probably think my name is Ronald. A lot of people probably,
really?
Because so many people call me Ron, you know
okay.
what I'm saying?
Okay.
So, just to keep it simple.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
So where are you from?
I'm originally from Camden, you know, born.
Camden, New Jersey.
Camden, New Jersey.
Okay.
Born in Cooper Hospital.
Right.
On a Sunday. I mean, after that, I went to Philly for the first couple years of my life.
What year? What year would you say you were born?
1980.
I'm. What'd you say? What year were you born, if you care to say? Okay, 1980.
Yeah, for sure.
Do you claim a neighborhood?
I mean, Kramer Hill. Gotta be where I claim because, you know, I grew up in, I was born, my mom lived downtown 4th Street.
Okay.
Went from 4th Street to East Camden.
Okay.
I lived in McGuire Projects. My grandpa lived in on Moore Street.
Okay.
You know, my grandma, I forget the name of the street, but you know the high rise that's right, it's in East Camden. I forget the name of it. It's the old, you know, the housing authority where all the old people live at.
Oh, McGuire. McGuire, there is the Westfield Acres in East Camden.
Nah, it's over by, closer to Philly. I mean, closer to like...
Oh, Northgate.
Yeah, but nah, not Northgate though. My dad is from Northgate, actually.
Okay.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah,
your
yeah,
dad's
yeah.
from Northgate. Interesting.
Yeah, yeah. Well, all over. I mean, how I go in Camden. People... You don't really stay in one. Very few people stay in one spot the whole time you in Camden.
True.
So,
that's
like
true.
I said, I went from Benson Street. I went from 4th Street to Benson Street to Carmen Street right next to Wilson.
So you were from downtown to East Camden.
To East Camden. Then from East Camden over to Kramer Hill.
Right.
But you will catch me on Moore Street. You can catch me all over the place. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
Out Parkside, I might have been coming to kick it with you. I was just the
right.
Kramer dude all over.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
So I can't, if I have to claim a place, I have to claim Kramer Hill because that's where I live.
Right,
know?
Right, right.
But I lived in Kramer Hill and went to Camden High.
So I just come out and say, you were my best friend growing up.
Facts.
So people from Parkside used to be like, yo, where's Sharon from? I would say Kramer Hill. Like, he from Kramer Hill.
Basically.
Right, right. Yeah. Okay. How would you describe Camden growing up or your neighborhood, Camden? How would you describe it? Like for example, was it a wealthy neighborhood? Was it a safe neighborhood? Was it poor? Was it dangerous? Was it gangsta? Was it okay? Would you raise your kids there? Like, how would you describe?
No. I wouldn't raise my kids there.
Right. Why
me
not?
Personally.
Why not?
It's just so much that can happen. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's just so much that can happen anytime. But I wouldn't change growing up in Camden.
All right, so describe. How was how was Camden for you? Like, what was the neighborhood like?
It was always like a low level threat of danger all the time, but it never affected my life. It's kind of like how I'm seeing the whole COVID situation right now. COVID to me is like living in a bad neighborhood.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Because you gotta be skeptical. You know, you gotta be diligent, but you at the same time you outside. You know, right. At the same time you're outside, you're like, I hope nothing happened.
Right.
And you just living your life, and before you know it, you look back, a year done went past.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
Kind of like that.
Okay. Well, you mentioned your little brother, so you were not an only child.
Definitely not.
So if you are you the oldest or the youngest, first of all? You're the oldest.
Yeah.
What is the age gap between you and your youngest sibling?
All right, so my siblings that I grew up
with. Well, yeah, the ones you grew up with. What's the age gap between you and your youngest sibling?
10 years.
10 years. All right, so if you are, so I'm going to do this. If you are 15 years old,
mm-hmm.
List your siblings. You don't have to say their names, but how old are they? If you're 15.
If I'm 15, one is 10.
Okay. And that, is it a brother or sister?
It's my brother.
Okay, you got a 10-year-old brother.
I would have a 7 or 8-year-old sister.
Okay.
And then I would have an infant little brother.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you being the oldest, how would you describe that growing up in that house?
I always been the same dude no matter what. I always just did my own thing. I was like the dude, I'd be like, yo, I'm out. And then I'm gone. And then I come back and I'm like, I'm back. So, you know, it wasn't really a situation where it was like I always had to look out for my younger brothers or my younger sister. My brother, Buck, he kind of held it down. He always been his own dude too.
Right.
You know, especially with the hand game and all that. He always been kind of nice with that.
Okay.
So, you know, when I was home, though, it was just more fun. We'd just be cracking jokes on each other. Like, you know, when I was a kid, I was silly, man. So,
right.
It was just like nonstop your mom jokes, even though we all had the same mom. It was nonstop Peter Bed jokes. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, rustling. We was, you know, you got three boys in the crib, you know, all at the same time. It's pandemonium. So and a sister.
The fact that you just said you could just be like, I'm out.
Yeah.
A lot of teenagers, period, can't say that because they are raising their little brothers and sisters.
Right.
So are we to assume that you grew up with a stable environment? Like, absolutely. Did you grow up with both parents?
My mom and my stepdad, for sure, was right there the whole time.
And that's crazy because you are the minority in the hood.
Facts.
All right, right?
Facts.
So I think, I was just discussing it on another interview that I think these are the levels. So if the fifth level, and we're talking about percentages of kids that grow up in the hood, mm-hmm. Probably the least percentage is a kid who says, I live with just my dad.
Yeah.
You agree to that?
Yeah, I would
agree. That's like the rarest thing. Like, you live with only your dad?
I agree with that.
And number two, right behind that, is kids who have both parents.
The whole time.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, because you hear a lot of people were like, yeah, I live with my mom and my dad until I was like 12 or until I was 11 or whatever age it was.
Right.
The whole time is super rare.
100%.
So how many guys did you grow up with? People, period.
Not a lot.
Exactly.
Not a lot.
So is kids who live with just their dad.
Right.
We talking about the hood that we know, that we grew up in.
Right.
Kids who have both parents, that's number two. That is rare.
Right.
And then like in the middle, that number three is like, let's say foster kids, right? The foster kids in the hood. I think it's more foster kids than kids who have both parents.
Which is sad.
The fourth level is kids who live with somebody in their family, like particularly their grandma, right? I live with my grandma or my aunt or my uncle or sometimes a cousin or in some cases their older sister or something like that, but a family member that's not their parent.
Right.
And then probably the number one percentage, the biggest percentage is kids who live with just their mom. So you are from a small minority of kids who grew up with both parents.
Not only that, I had the whole shebang. I had both my parents, I had my grandmom on both sides, my grandpop on both sides. I had crazy aunts. You know, right. I got one of them ridiculous big families. I had cousins all over the place.
Right.
So I just have family, you know, half of the good percentage of Canada is my cousin. You know what I'm saying?
Really?
So, yeah, I just had a whole different scenario from a whole lot of people.
Okay. For okay. Sure. What would you say was your relationship with your parents? With your mom and your stepdad?
It was good. I mean, it was good. I wasn't a bad kid. You know, I was silly, you know. But the only thing that for sure that everyone would say about me is I was out. You know what I'm saying? Like, I get up and whatever I wanted to do that day, if I wanted to come kick it with you on Parkside, I'll walk to Parkside. You know what I mean?
Right.
If I wanted to go to my grandma's house on Moore Street, I'll walk to Moore Street. But I wasn't the type of dude that was, like, in the house all the time. So
okay.
It was cool. When I would come home, you know, after I got a certain age, I would come home and I would just kind of do my thing, play, you know, Nintendo, Sega Genesis, whatever it is, do
right.
my own work.
Right.
So it was a good relationship, you know what I'm saying? But I did have, like, a structure in terms of, you know, My stepdad was a disciplinary type of guy.
Right.
My mom was like, you know, the school teacher, like
right.
in spirit, not just
right.
like by profession, but like in spirit. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? So it was kind of like a little ghetto Huxtable type scenario.
Nah,
you know
and,
what I mean?
And I can personally vouch for that.
Yeah.
I remember
yeah.
in high school when I was going through what I was going through, I would be at your house at least once, twice a week.
Yeah.
And that once, twice a week, I felt like your family was my family.
Facts. And not only you. It was a lot. It was a couple people. I got, you know, a couple friends out there. You know, every night it was somebody at my crib. Or if they wasn't staying the night or there for dinner, we would be on the porch playing Nintendo, Genesis, all the kids from the whole neighborhood because we had all the video games and all this type of stuff.
And you was probably the only family in the hood that had both parents.
Facts. that's a Snapple fact right there. That's
right.
That's real rap.
Right.
But yeah, so it was a good upbringing. Like, I wouldn't change nothing about it. And, you know, one thing, you know,
and that's something that you and I have in common.
Yeah.
Because I grew up with both parents too.
There you go.
And you know that.
Yeah.
So it's like we were two minorities.
All right. And you know what? For real, like, you asked me if I would raise my kids in Camden, and I wouldn't. But one thing I will say, growing up in Camden with both parents and going out into the world, you're way more equipped than an average
exactly.
person.
Exactly.
Way you're more equipped.
It's a whole different childhood.
It's a whole different scenario because, you know, I got a daughter that's in college right now. I got one that's going to college pretty soon, and,
okay.
and it's scary because there's so much they don't know about the world. When we were, you know, 10th, 11th, 12th grade, we knew how to move.
Right.
You know,
right.
It wasn't all good. We knew, nah, we're not going to go down there because it ain't all
we
good.
We was already
we
super street smart
here.
By
we
that.
Already knew about
right.
it. Or, you know, we get into a situation, we know to defuse the situation as opposed to escalate the situation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody don't have those skills. And it translated well for me. I've done really well. I attribute it to growing up in Camden.
I bet you, speaking of growing up in Camden,
sure.
I bet you don't remember all the schools that you went to.
I do.
Okay. Let's go. Kindergarten, go.
Kindergarten, I went to Kramer.
Kramer is where?
Kramer is in East Camden.
East Camden.
It's two blocks over from
McGraw?
The projects.
Oh, from the projects.
From
okay.
the project, from Benson Street, where I lived at, two blocks away.
Okay.
You know?
So your walk to school was like 5 minutes.
5 minutes. And I walked by myself from the second day of school.
Right.
For the rest of my life, I walked to school every day by myself.
Your mom never came and picked you up.
I mean, you know, on occasion.
Sporadically, like, she
yeah,
might be
yeah.
in the car. You're like, yes.
Yeah. The teacher called her. You know,
right.
I was acting crazy. But, yeah, nah. For the most part, I walked to school every day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you went from to Kramer from K through what?
To third grade.
K to third. So what was your experience like in Kramer? If you remember.
it was crazy. You gotta remember, this is 85.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So this is, you know, crack coming in. It's
right.
getting a little crazy.
Right.
You know, this is the when people's moms was first getting strung out on drugs and the little kids are looking to the older brothers as parents.
Right.
And the older brother's not on the right path. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So kids getting left back. You know, you in the same grade, you're thinking everybody five. You got 7-year-olds beating up the 5-year-olds. It was
right.
crazy.
Right.
And that's how I kind of learned, like, my social skills.
Okay.
You know, because when you get in a situation where you like, listen, if we get into a physical brawl, this ain't going to end well for me. You
right,
know what I'm
right,
saying?
Right, right,
so you kind of learn how to...
Were there any groups or posses or teams that you had to deal with at Kramer?
The Fruit Posse.
The Fruit Posse does exist.
The Fruit Posse,
you from East Camden, well, and you know.
It used to be spray painted. Like, when you go through Utah,
right.
and you go, when you first go to Moore Street, it's a little, like a... a brick, like this brick place right here, and then it's a gate. It's someone's yard.
Right.
They used to say the Fruit Posse right there.
Now, officially, they were called the Fruit Posse. The kids, if you was in the neighborhood, we just called them fruit. Like, here come fruit.
They come to fruit. That sounds crazy. Here come fruit.
Yeah, oh, that's here crazy. They come. How would you describe fruit? Like, how would you say they terrorize that? If in your opinion, do you feel like they terrorize East Camden? At least their side of East Camden?
Well, see, here's the thing.